started when an angry German man said what he said. He got himself into their minds with junk inside his head. Now he's got tons of followers, soon they'll fill the world with dread, he's Hitler.
Born in 1889 in the rural town of Meskirch, Martin Heidegger was a prominent German philosopher of the 20th century, today most well known for his stances on phenomenology and existentialism, which makes him pretty cool in my book. However, the biggest controversy of his legacy was that he was also a Nazi, which is kind of a deal breaker today. That does beg the question then. Why then is Heidegger still considered one of the most important philosophers of the 20th century? Well, first off, Heidegger is notoriously confusing to read. When discussing phenomenology, for instance, Heidegger describes it as thus: to let that which shows itself be seen from itself in of every way in which it shows itself from itself. In short, he's got a pretty big brain. But unlike how upper-level philosophy classes might make it out to be, that doesn't exactly equate to applicable importance. So, what did Heidegger do? Well, to reiterate a bit, Heidegger actually came from a pretty humble upbringing, unlike most of the people we read about. He was very intelligent, reading the works of Aristotle, Descartes, Kant, Kierkegaard, and the Pringles mascot, Nietzsche himself. Eventually, Heidegger would find himself under the tutelage of a certain Edmund Husserl, who planted the roots for phenomenological sociology. That's important. We'll come back to that later. Heidegger would eventually become a professor at the University of Freiburg himself, teaching the likes of Herbert Marcuse, who is later known for being associated with the Frankfurt School.
Oh yeah, it's all coming together.
Heidegger was also an instructor to Hannah Arendt, a notable philosopher who Heidegger later had an affair with, despite being over twice her age. Not to mention, she was of Jewish descent. It's complicated, I'm sure. Regardless, in 1933, Heidegger joined the Nazi Party. Although he resigned as a lecturer soon after in 1934, during his time, he gave a few talks that were not so denouncing of the party. A contemporary topic of contention today is to what extent Heidegger really was supportive of the Nazi Party. Some scholars believe that Heidegger was pressured into making the sentiments he did, and that his ideologies also did not ultimately align with the party. But it's also true that the private sentiments he wrote in his titled Black Notebooks provided some insights into anti-Semitic passages in a philosophical context. Whatever that means. Heidegger writes his magnum opus, Sinn und Zeit, or Being in Time if you can't speak German, like me, in 1927, and it goes over a lot of the key facets to his thinking. It's also known to be super dense and confusing, which is great for me. A little fun fact, but the first edition of Being in Time is actually dedicated to Husserl, who essentially tells Heidegger something along the lines of, "Wow, Martin, this is garbage," and yeets it into the garbage, after which Heidegger proceeds to remove the dedication in the following edition. Spicy. In Being in Time, Heidegger discusses, or attempts to communicate, the key ideas to his ontological view, or, put simply, the metaphysical study of beings, specifically, humans. Basically, it's a little 590-page thing on how people are. Kind of like another book. Okay, so as of now, I'm going to try to explain what Heidegger is trying to say in Being in Time, so put on your seatbelts and watch out, because it gets a little complicated. So basically, at the core of Heidegger's work lies the idea of Dasein, which means life or existence or literally their being. Heidegger uses it to describe the social being or the mode of being, that is, to be a human. It's not a biological person or a specific entity, but rather, as Wheeler puts it, a way of life.
Wow, it's almost like we're talking about a kind of society here.
I know. Interesting. Dasein is characteristic of humans' very beings to be engaged with the world. It is a condition that could be described as being in the world, or it's a sort of natural everydayness. At the same time as Dasein, there's also an inherent angst, which generally boils down to Heidegger's idea that most people are not living a truthful or authentic life. Heidegger does also purport that this angst is a sort of fundamental existential mood of Dasein, in which it actually is the feeling that results from being. What Heidegger's worried about in terms of inauthenticity is this sort of other Dasman, as he says, or they, which seeks distraction and conform themselves to inauthentic aspects such as idleness, ambiguity. In an effort to spare you from my further attempts at broken German, a few more key terms that Heidegger discusses in relevance to Dasein are projection, thrownness, and fallenness. The future is described by projection and thrownness for the past, and it's attributed to how people are sort of thrown into the world. Fallenness describes the current present, and as Heidegger says in Being and Time, Dasein has, in the first instance, fallen away from itself as an authentic potentiality for being itself, and has fallen into the world. Heidegger goes into greater detail about what exactly fallenness, projection, and thrownness are characterized by, actions and perceptions of people at those points. But generally, those things, where do they get you? It's an idea of temporality. In short, it basically boils down to everyone dies. It's in relation to what Heidegger calls the nothing, which is inherently connected to the Dasein. Existence for the Dasein is inherently and essentially temporal. Sort of getting that through temporality allows the space of possibilities within the past, present, and future, in which the Dasein is a being which gives itself access to the sense of being. I know that's a lot for a basic gist, and if you don't get it, that's all right. That's most of us. Join the crew. But hopefully some of this stuff sounds familiar. For me, Heidegger's discussion of Dasein seems to allude a lot to Marx's description of the species being. And although there is some conflict on the facets that dissuade people away from this natural state of being, I think it's something interesting to look into. In discussing Marx's idea of the species being, alienation involves the sort of idea that you cannot express yourself. There's this sort of estrangement that results from people being unable to act according to their will, sometimes not even knowing it is in their will due to these external forces and demands that constrain them. For Marx, when labor is objectified, the result is that workers are unable to realize their humanity. This is strikingly similar to Heidegger. There's this strong sense of dissonance that results when one is unable to be that self, despite a strong desire to do so, a naturalness to do so. As Fox describes, it is a profound inadequacy or lack in being that results in this heavy and pervasive mood that Heidegger categorizes under his description of angst or anxiety. Finally, Heidegger was prominent in the field of phenomenology, sort of taking over after Husserl, who sort of set the seeds for the field. Phenomenology is how the social world is constructed through everyday experience, rather than through philosophical or scientific ideas. Husserl described actions and minds of humans through intentionality. Heidegger worked as Husserl's assistant in his early career, but soon developed his own ideas and progress for phenomenology. In fact, much of the way in which Heidegger approaches his writing of Being and Time is through phenomenology. Heideggerian phenomenology is not entirely focused on experience as we traditionally think of phenomenology. Rather, it takes the experience that we talk about in phenomenology and sort of directs it to the sort of a priori or things that come before it that sort of allow for these experiences to occur and shape the way they are, which, of course, for Heidegger is Dasein. In a given activity, instead of Husserl, who would have used subjectivity and consciousness to discuss things through phenomenology, Heidegger is more apt to discuss it in terms of being with others. This sort of idea of everydayness that we discussed earlier. Instead of viewing the world in Geist or roles in social activity, Heidegger was more focused on social practice, which he felt was more important than just individual consciousness. In a way, Heidegger's phenomenology gives a more holistic view than the more individual forms of phenomenology, in that he acknowledges the existence that there is this day, there is this Dasman, and other people in society can affect others as the Dasein for either an authentic or inauthentic existence or move to action. Although he was and still is pretty hard to understand, I think that Heidegger has a lot of things to contribute to what we learned this semester, and overall gives a new perspective to phenomenology in particular. Just remember, he was a Nazi.